testing. Well, this game is one of the more interesting games that we have already in week number three. We are looking at playoff positions, and playoff positions are very hard to come by. Of 64 teams, only 16 will make the playoffs, meaning that every game is almost like a playoff in itself, almost like a double elimination, because when 12 games, in 12 games, three losses is going to be very hard to try and get a position. Looking first at, you know, our game, Oklahoma and North Carolina. Oklahoma is number 12 in the nation. North Carolina is number 14. They're both in the same conference. They are both 1-0-1. Remember, well, North Carolina is 1-0-1, and Oklahoma A&M is 2-0. For the introduction to the teams, we're going to take a look right now at the North Carolina Tar Heels. The North Carolina Tar Heels come into this game with high hopes. They played a couple games, a couple good games. North Carolina beat Notre Dame 14-7, and then they tied Purdue 21-21. Taking a look at the skilled positions. Rogers, the quarterback, running the football. Let's take a look. There we go. Running, let's take a look at the quarterback position now. Justice is 9 of 16 throwing the football, and he has a touchdown, no interceptions. Rogers, 12 of 32 for 166, two touchdowns and a pick. The wide receivers, Rogers looks to be 45 rushes for 153 yards. Not that much receiving. My goodness, not that much there. Offensive line, there has been Zafarin. Zafarin has opened up the most holes. Your buddy's given up a sack and had a bad time at it. Cox leads everybody in defensive ends with tackles. And it'll be very big. Linebackers, Mitten, the outside linebacker, he has 16 of them. Defensive backs, interceptions and deflections. Justice has 4 deflections. Clements doesn't deflect the intercepts. Kicking wise, Justice only with 1 field goal attempt, and he missed it, but he made all 5 extra points returning. They look pretty good in what they do. Rogers and Justice, very good at what he does, and both of them getting about over, a little over 20 on that one. Again, we take a look at the team. The offense is ranked right in the middle of 64 teams. Their passing is not too bad for North Carolina, the 14th, at 120 yards a game in a league where passing is the premium. They're 13th in total drives for touchdowns. Total passes complete for touchdowns. At 1 out of every 6 or 7 passes being a score. Interception, well, it's down low. They pass at a 71.6% rate there. And a third down, they're only getting a third of that. So they're going to have to bring up some stuff today. For Oklahoma State, on the other hand, they are number 12. Oklahoma State, number 12. As we take a look at Oklahoma State. So taking a look, Oklahoma State now, as we go over to them, here they are. Taking a look at their games. They beat Alabama 1961, 21-10, and they beat Wisconsin 25-7. Offensively, a little bit better with points. They're in the upper tier of offensive games. They're only completing a little over a third of their passes, which is terrible. But they're up there in touchdown percentage, but the interception percentage is up there. The turnovers, they average a little over 1.5 a game on offense, and they get the other team to turn the ball over at the same rate. Third down percentage are almost half, which means first and second down are all right. And who does that? The quarterbacks. They got 2 of them, Fenimore and Thomas. They have thrown the ball 28 times in 2 games. You don't want to expect too much more. From that, running the football, they are 15 rushes for 117 yards for Fenimore, 26 for 139 for Thomas. Other running backs here, 85 yards for Meinert. And as you see, the quarterbacks are leading everybody in the running. They're the best athletes out here. Wide receivers, Armstrong with three, Van Poole with two, and Bruton with one catch. 10 good holes by Cole, the tackle. They're going to be running near him. Cheek with 13 tackles here. The linebacker, Jeffers, he has 16 of them. And the defensive backs, the interceptions are Watson. And Watson, that's going to be very big. Kicking-wise, again, Long is 0 for 1. They don't kick many field goals here, which could be pretty good. But again, when you take a look at extra points, he's only 4 of 7, and he's not 100% like North Carolina. On the other hand, let's talk about both these teams, even though we're here and looking at Oklahoma State. Oklahoma A&M. We're going to call them Oklahoma A&M because they are Oklahoma A&M. They're at home. They're in the same conference. They're in the same division. And whenever they're in the same division, in the same conference, these two teams stick out. North Carolina's 14, Oklahoma A&M is 12, meaning that this game is very big. You play everybody in your division once, and you play five games against people outside. And you want to win all those games and people in your division to do it, but they go by overall record. Remember, they go by overall record, so, you know, that's one of the big things is you need to have a good record. You need to be a power record. You need to be good teams when you play good teams. If you just play the teams at the bottom, that is no good. So anyway, we're about to kick off here, ready to go in Boone Pickens Stadium. Here comes the national anthem, and it's going to look good. Here comes the Oklahoma State Band for the national anthem. What a national anthem here by Oklahoma State, and we're going to be ready to go as I keep saying Kentucky, but North Carolina will kick off to Oklahoma to get this started, a very important football game, because the winner here will have the upper leg. We only play 12 games, remember that, 12 games, and right now we have two of them done, and after tonight it'll be a quarter of the way through already in 3 days. So ready to go for North Carolina, in to kick off, and we're underway. It is, where is it? It looks like it's going out of bounds. What a horrible kick, and it
kicking
is.
Team.
It's going to be an out-of-bounds kick. Cox, oh my God, was that a terrible kick. And North Carolina, terribly, and here's going to be a first down. This is a single-wing offense, if you've never seen this before. So a single wing for Oklahoma State. It's going to be first down and 10. First down, the snap. They're going to fake it. They give it to the running back. That's going to be right up to Hankins. And Hankins on a trap. It's going to be second down. It's going to be wing right, second down, and 7. Very methodical, very plotting offense, but can be explosive. Back, he's going to look. He's going to run it the other way. Here he goes, first down and more. Here comes the quarterback, and down he goes. That's going to be Thomas. And Thomas is going to be a first down. He rushes for a lot. Very big for Oklahoma. Oklahoma very big. It's going to be first down and 10. And they're going to snap it to the up. No, Thomas is going to have it. He's going to throw it deep, and it's intercepted. Intercepted, and that's North Carolina that has it. A very big interception, And Kennedy will take it, and it kind of ruins it early on for Oklahoma State. A big, big North Carolina interception here. Very, very big. And this is just a very early beginning. You gotta see this. But anyway, North Carolina will take over, and look at their formation. This should be fun. See North Carolina again. North Carolina, very, very big in what they do. North Carolina took that away, Oklahoma State, early on, and I am telling you right now that it is not what they wanted, but it's going to be first down. This is an actual formation. My God, look at it. First down back from the 1940s. They snap it. No, the quarterback's going to take it. Here comes Justice, and he gets two. It'll be second down. They threw originally a flag, but they pick it up. It'll be second down and eight. They're in a single. This is another single wing. You can see the quarterback is actually the fullback, really. Second down, it's going to be back. Justice will throw, and it's going to be incomplete. It'll be third down. Third down for North Carolina. Third and eight. Back to throw, and looking, he's going to throw it again. It's going to be caught to the tight end of the first down. First down, a gain of 17. They go out of the single wing, and they're throwing a ball all over the place. And now Rodgers comes in at quarterback. Man, they rotate him. First down. This is going to be wild and weird. First down for North Carolina. They're in Oklahoma territory. Back to throw, looking. He's going to throw. Rodgers, it's incomplete. And it's going to be incomplete, nearly intercepted. And it's going to be second down. Second down and 10 for North Carolina. It is raining here. It's raining on the artificial turf of Boone Pickens Stadium right now. Pouring down rain. It's going to be second down. And he's going to keep it right up the middle, and that is Rodgers. And he gains 7. It's going to be third down. Third down for North Carolina. They want to drive it down the field. North Carolina, it's going to be third down and 3. There, you know this is going for it. And here comes Rodgers again up the middle on a first down. So a gain of 4, and this is really going well for North Carolina, and the Tar Heels have it. They're driving down the field. This will be the 7th play of the drive. Already 6 plays, 30 yards, 7th play. Back, and it's going to be a handoff right up to the left side, a fumble, and it is Oklahoma A&M. Oklahoma A&M gets it. It was a fumble, a big fumble, and the rain happened. And the rain happened for Oklahoma State, and Oklahoma State will take over. My goodness. Oklahoma State takes over. We'll be back in a bit. Ready to go here. Oklahoma A&M's offense will take over, and it is after the turnover, a fumble. So this is a crazy game so far. It looks like a game that you find in the Sandlots, really. First down. The snap, it's going to be Thomas. Thomas, the quarterback, to the left-hand side. Here comes Thomas, and a gain of 9, and actually 10. They're going to give it to him for a first down for Oklahoma State. Oklahoma A&M, I would say. A first down for Oklahoma A&M. The snap, it's going to be Thomas again. Thomas, and he's tackled. He loses 6. Looks like he wanted to throw, and it's going to be second down. You remember their first possession. Fenimore will actually come in for quarterback now. Fenimore coming in, and they change their formation up a little bit. It's going to be second down. Second down. It's going to be back to throw. Fenimore, he's going to run it himself. Here comes Fenimore up for a first down. A gain of 17, and Oklahoma A&M will get a first down. Very, very big. Oklahoma A&M is on the drive. First down with some of these formations. You can't tell who's on offense and defense. And Fenimore, he's going to keep it to the outside. Here comes Fenimore, and he gets a few. He's going to get three. It's going to be second down. This is a single wing. Again, a variation of the single wing. Thomas comes in at quarterback. So Thomas will come in at quarterback. It'll be second down and 7 for Oklahoma State. Back to throw. Actually, it's going to be run. It's going to be the running back. That's going to be Reynolds. And Hankins will give to Reynolds. It'll be third down. You see, anybody can give to anybody in this kind of a formation. Third down and 3. Third and 3. And that's going to be the throw, and it's incomplete. So it'll be fourth down. What are they going to do? Are they going to punt it? Yes, they are. They're going to punt it. And trying to return it. Let's see what happens here. So Oklahoma A&M will kick it. It'll be down to the 9-yard line, and it'll be a first down for North Carolina. So playing field position right now, this game has actually been quite interesting. Really quite interesting, because both teams moving the ball except for that last one. It was turnover, and punt. So it's going to be first down and 10 for North Carolina. Let's see what they can do. The snap, it's going to be their quarterback, Rogers. Rogers to the left-hand side. There's a penalty. Let's see what it is.
Offsides, defense, 5-yard penalty.
So they're going to accept that. It'll be on the defense. It'll be now first down and 5. First and 5 for North Carolina. And the snap to Rogers. He's going to look. He throws to the near side. It's going to be dropped. He tried to throw to Cox, and it was dropped. It'll be second down. Second down and 5 for North Carolina. Back, Rogers again. He'll run maybe a gain of 1. It'll be third down and 4. They got to be careful. It's raining out here. The opening kickoff was terrible. Justice comes in at quarterback. So Justice will come in at quarterback. It's on a single wing. Third down and 4. Justice. No, yeah, it's going to be him. He throws. It's complete and a first down. Grimes with the tackle, but he throws for Powell. And he hits Powell, and it'll be a first down. So Rogers will come back into the game for North Carolina. They're on the attack now. First down. Back, and it's going to be Powell. Maybe that's Rogers actually running it. And it'll be second down. So second down for North Carolina. You can see their offense and how it runs. Second down, it's going to be the snap, and maybe a yard there for Rogers. It'll be third down, and now they got to throw. But they at least get it out. Justice will come in. So Justice will come in. Third down and 9. Third and 9. And the snap, he's going to take a look. He's going to throw it, and it's incomplete. Bobbling the ball, it'll be fourth down. Fourth down, and now they're going to punt. So it's going to be North Carolina punting as the first quarter is winding down. They're going to kick it out of their own end, and it'll just be a fair catch at the 36. Fair catch at the 36-yard line, and right now this has been an interesting game. Don't get me wrong, it's tension-filled. It is, and they're battling for first place. There's a lot of tension here. Tennessee looking really good. Like seriously good. 50 Tennessee looking very good. The Tennessees are looking good. And when you take a look at a game like this, this is big. I mean, you never know so far. It'll be first down for Oklahoma A&M. And here comes Thomas. He's going to throw it deep and a little bit too far. And Thomas is hit as he threw, and it'll be second down. Second down and 10. Back is Thomas. He's going to run it himself to the left side. He gets half of it back. He gains 5. And it'll be third down and 5 down. Third and 5 for Oklahoma State. It is a game of territorial position. Thomas, he's going to run. He gets a first down. Here's Thomas down to the 44. Down to the 43-yard line and a first down. So Thomas gets it, and Oklahoma A&M will have it. Oklahoma A&M is driving first down. And Thomas again to the left-hand side. A little bit of razzle-dazzle there. Nothing there. It'll be second down. Second down. About a minute to go here in the first quarter. Back Thomas to throw. He's going to run it himself. Here comes Thomas. He fumbled the ball. And it is North Carolina's. And North Carolina has the ball. It's a turnover. And North Carolina fumbles it, and they're loving it. We're going to keep it here. But North Carolina, as we keep it here, 5 seconds to go in a quarter, and we are still scoreless. But this has been offensive all up and down the field. And now we're going to run one play. And this will be it. One play, and that's going to be it. So Rodgers will be in a quarterback. It's going to be first down. And Rodgers will have it. He's going to run and maybe get a yard. And nothing there. The rain is making everything go absolutely ballistic. And that's going to be the end of the first quarter. The end of the first quarter here. The rain is making everything just go crazy. But this is a heck of a game so far. Well, after the first quarter, now we're about ready to go to the second quarter here. A crazy, crazy first quarter here, as just very big in what they did. Both teams offensively playing very well, and it's going to be first down and 10. When you take a look at the box score, it's 84-44 in yards, so very good. North Carolina, the only team passing the ball, first downs 4-3. But I'll tell you what, it's been very interesting. It's going to be first down for Justice in North Carolina. They give it to Justice. Justice, he's going to run to the left side. He'll get a few. He gains 3. It'll be second down and 7. Very, very big game. These teams know it, too. Second down and 7. Back. And, oh, it's going to be the running back, and it's incomplete. Trying to throw it. Oh, my goodness. And that was a kind of a trick play. I don't know. It's a single wing. Anything can happen. And now returning it will be Oklahoma A&M. And this one will be big for field position. Way down. And he's going to get it up to the 20-yard line. 50 yards. And remember, in this type of day and age, territory is huge. Territory is very big. As North Carolina and Oklahoma, here comes Oklahoma A&M to begin. First down, Boone Pickens Stadium. And now they're going to hand it off right up the middle, only a yard gain, and that's going to be Grimes. So Grimes with the run, it's going to be second down. Second down. Back to throw, Thomas. He's going to run it himself. Thomas, a first down up to the 35, and he just runs. You remember when you pass, you can just 50-50 passing and running. That's why the attempts are down, and it's going to be a first down. So Oklahoma is moving the ball really well, over 100 total yards for the day. First down, back the handoff, and it's going to be up the left side, a penalty, and let's see what it is.
Holding offense, 10-yard penalty.
Duckett with the hold. They're going to accept it, and they're going to be back there. So Fenimore will have it. It's going to be a first down for Oklahoma. So Oklahoma A&M, very big first down. Back to throw, Fenimore. He's looking. He's going to throw way down the field, and it is intercepted. The second one of the day, and he is going down to the 17-yard line, and he's down to the 10, maybe the 10-yard line. Maseko with the interception. And Maseko has the interception, a very big interception. And North Carolina is celebrating right now. And it's North Carolina right now. This is exactly what they want to do. So I will tell you this much, that this is a tough game, but when you take a look at some of the scores that we see here, Army still has not given up a point yet. Syracuse has given up a field goal. How about that all year? And as you take a look down, Pitt, we saw Pitt earlier. Pitt is leading Nebraska 10-7. Pitt, so far a lot of winless teams they've played. They haven't played a team that has had a win when they played them opening day, 0-1 and 0-2. So they're trying to win and go 2-1. Because if you win your group, you're in no matter what, then it's the highest 8. So that's very big. Penn State up on Indiana. We played that as a fake matchup before, and that was a good game, even though Indiana was a favorite. And Tennessee is all over Navy. It's 19-3 there. Tennessee, all the Tennessees, 1950 and 1956, are emerging as favorites here, but we don't know about their schedule. You really don't know about that, and it's going to be first down for North Carolina here as they take over after the interception. Rodgers, he's going to have a Rodgers to the left side, and he's going to be nowhere. It'll be second down. Second down and goal. They have to score a touchdown here. Second and goal for North Carolina. Snap, Rodgers again. He's going to take a look, and he's tackled by Hargrove. And Hargrove came in, and he tackled him. It's going to be third down, and Justice will come in at quarterback. And Justice will come in at quarterback. It's going to be third down. Justice. And it's going to be Justice again, looking end zone, incomplete. And now a field goal attempt. He's 0-1 in a year. This will be the first field goal attempt. This will be the first make if he makes it. He's 0-1 for the year. So here we go. This is going to be very, very big. The kick is going to be over. It is up and it is good. And North Carolina has a lead. They lead. And Justice nails it. And he has an early 3-0 lead. North Carolina, well, I'll tell you, so far, North Carolina early on, a score here And they go up on the road. It was set up by a turnover for Oklahoma A&M. Oklahoma A&M is moving the football, but they're turning it over. That's big. So we're going to go right now. And here comes the kickoff for North Carolina. They're going to kick it deep. And this one stays in bounds. Returned by Oklahoma A&M up to the 29-yard line. So return to 28. It's going to be first down. Thomas will be the quarterback here. It's pouring down rain. First down for Oklahoma State. And back, here's Thomas. He runs to the left side. Thomas again to the 43. And it'll be a first down, a gain of 15. He's tackled at the 44. So here comes Oklahoma A&M, a first down. Fenimore is coming in at quarterback. And the snap, back, Fenimore. He's going to have it. He runs to the left side. And Fenimore, here comes Maseko with the tackle. And he gains 7. It'll be second down. So Thomas will come in. Back and forth, they rotate. So it'll be second down and 4. Thomas, they actually hand it off. It's going to be running back right up the middle. Maseko, another tackle, but it's going to be Reynolds. And Reynolds makes it a first down, a big first down for Reynolds. And they are rotating running backs here like rotisserie. It's like rotisserie chicken. First down. Back in. That's going to be a running nothing play, as we call it, a loss of 1. It'll be second down. So second down, it'll be the fifth play of the drive for Oklahoma State. Oklahoma A&M run right up the middle, and it's nothing. He only gains 2. It'll be third down. So Reynolds has it. So Fenimore comes in at quarterback. Third down for Fenimore and Oklahoma. And, oh, the running back's going to throw it, and it's complete. It is complete. So it is big. Fenimore throws it to Armstrong, and that's big. So first down and 10, the running back has it. Now Thomas comes in. First down for Oklahoma. And the handoff, they get nothing there. That's going to be Reynolds, and he barely gets anything. He got 23 yards on 3 carries. It's going to be second down and 9. And the running back to the left-hand side, and he goes out of bounds. Nothing there, and they lose 3. Third down, it's going to be hard to make this. It's going to be really hard. Third down and 12. They need to get yards here. Third and 12. And there they go. Fenimore to the left-hand side. It's going to be closer. And he stopped at the 11-yard line. A gain of 9. It'll be fourth down. And now they're going to try and kick their first field goal of the year. They're going to try and kick their first field goal of the year. And it is fourth down and 3. So at 4th and 3, here they go. The snap back hits the line. It is up and it is good. And it is good right down the middle. And Oklahoma A&M has a lead. And Oklahoma A&M and a big, big answer to that North Carolina when they picked up the turnover. And right now, number 14 and number 12. This has been an exciting game so far. It is 3-3. More water and use the restroom as the kickoff now will happen. 3:29. It's going to be very big. They need to get this thing down the field. That's not a lot of time right now. The kick to the up back to the 25. Let's see what happens here. It's going to be first down. Rogers the quarterback now. The snap, and Rogers, he's going to run to the right side, up to about the 30-yard line, to the 31. It's going to be second down. That clock is going to be very, very big as The clock runs again. Here's Rodgers. Rodgers, nothing. Kohler, and he tried to throw, but nothing. He gets sacked. They lose four. And it'll be third down for North Carolina as they call a timeout. Here they go again. Rodgers, and he's sacked again by Jeffers. This is how you get a lot of the sacks here. And it's going to be fourth down. And Oklahoma A&M is going to keep their timeouts. So the punt now for North Carolina. It's going to be deep. A good punt. And this is, wait a second. He draws a loose ball. And it's going to be recovered by Cole. And it'll be Oklahoma's, though. Oklahoma A&M will keep it. And we're going to have 2 minutes to go here, so I just don't know what they're going to do. Whether they're going to run, it's a 3-3 game. Let's see what they have at Fenimore. And a penalty, and he gets about a couple yards. Let's see what happened. Powell with the stop.
Holding offense, 10-yard penalty.
Two timeouts. North Carolina might be able to get something back here. Thomas will have it. First down. Back, and they're going to give it to the running back. He gets a couple yards. That's going to be Reynolds, and only a couple here. North Carolina is going to call a timeout. They want to hold it and maybe get a punt. Oklahoma A&M is back, second down, and they're going to be back more. They move.
False start. Offense, 5-yard penalty. Repeat, second down.
That was Cole with the false start. So now Oklahoma A&M is going to be way back. Way back, second and 21. Nearing the half here. This game's taken forever. Now, all of a sudden, at this point, no good. That is Cox with no gain. Well, that isn't Cox, but it's going to be third down. Fenimore now after a North Carolina timeout. 1:29 to go. Third down and back to throw. Fenimore, he's going to run it himself. Fenimore up the middle. And Fenimore not even close. And it's going to be fourth down, and I really think that North Carolina, that saved North Carolina from doing anything. And I think they're just going to let the thing roll and take a knee. They're going to kick it, and it's going to be at the 5-yard line. Oklahoma A&M can stop the clock all three times. And this is going to be big. On a 59 yards, they didn't want a turnover. And here they go. This is big. Rodgers to the left-hand side. Rodgers close. And he's going to get, he ran. He gets 8 yards. Rodgers ran for 109 yards in the last game. And that's going to be a timeout. He, against Purdue, 66 Purdue, he had 23 rushes for 109 yards in his last game. So Rodgers is very good at running. It's going to be second down here, 20 seconds. Oklahoma A&M can stop the clock, and they go again, and maybe a gain of one. No, he's going to get nothing, and it's going to be third down. They're going to call timeout. They might fair catch it and then kick it through. Justice, the quarterback here, it's going to be third down. Third and two. And here's Justice. He gets a first down, and that'll end a half. They're just going to end the half here, and North Carolina is going to take it to the half, and that's going to be it. That's it, and North Carolina, very, very big in everything that they're doing right now. Very big, and they're going to receive the second half kick, but we are at halftime. You got to love some of this stuff right now at the half. It is right now 3-3, 3-3 right now in a game to decide. We'll give the upper hand to somebody in the division. So right now we're going to go to the marching band of right now. It is going to be the marching bands are coming out. So here's the halftime show.
It's halftime at Ohio Stadium with the...
So we'll be back after the half. Take a look at some of the stats.
Grab that box of popcorn and settle down in your seat. We're going to the movies. Tonight, the Ohio State University Marching Band has your ticket to a big-time halftime of Hollywood Blockbusters. Look up in the sky. Boone.
We're about ready to go here for the second half. A game in which has seen incredible things happen. Yeah, so now we're going to be ready to go for the second half. Kicking is Oklahoma A&M. They're going to kick it. They're going to kick it off. They dominated almost beyond 3-1. And that's going to be the kick up to the 45. This is up to the 47. It'll be a first down for North Carolina. They dominated the yards 3-1. Beyond 3-1. 180 to 55. And it's only 3-3 because of their three turnovers. First down and 10 for North Carolina. Here's Rogers, a quarterback, and he's going to gain a couple. No gain, actually. It'll be second down. Second down for North Carolina. Second and 10. Rogers, and he's going to hand off, fumbled the football, and it is Oklahoma A&M has it. Oklahoma A&M has the football, and Oklahoma A&M will take it. Oklahoma A&M will have the football, and they take over, and that's very big. Because Oklahoma A&M with a tied game, North Carolina came out of the gate, and they just decided to fumble the ball away. This is big, I'm telling you right now. This is very big, a very big possession for Oklahoma State, for Oklahoma A&M. The running back to the left side, here he goes. He's breaking down, another fumble, and he picks it up, the wing back, and it's going to be a first down, another fumble. There is rain everywhere. This is a crazy game, but a first down for Oklahoma A&M. And North Carolina will... Actually, a new quarterback will come in, Fenimore, for Oklahoma A&M, first down. After the single wing, and running to the left is Fenimore. Fenimore is going to be a gain of 10 and a first down. So Fenimore will have it. It'll be a first down for Oklahoma. First down, Oklahoma. You can see they're in a single wing. And here is Fenimore again to the left-hand side, and tackled again by Justice. After a gain of 9, it'll be second down and 1. Second down and 1. Thomas is in at quarterback now. Second down, Thomas. Thomas, he's going to hand it off. It's going to be a fumble. Fumble, and it's going to be picked up. And it's going to be Cox. It caused it, but Oklahoma A&M gets the ball. That's twice they fumbled the ball. This is like a rugby match. With the way the fumbles are going, it's going to be first down, Oklahoma A&M. The snap, they're going to run around. He's going to take left side and a touchdown. Thomas puts it in and a touchdown for Oklahoma A&M. Thomas runs to the left. And Oklahoma A&M, what a play. Oklahoma has dominated in yards, 226 to 54. They're showing everybody who's king of this division. And this is a big touchdown. North Carolina's gonna have to They're going to have to regroup. So now the extra point. It is up and it is missed it. He missed it. It's no good. It's 9-3 now. A 9-3 score here in the third. And we're going to keep it here as they kick off. So 9-3. And now they're going to kick off here. Kicking it. It'll be short and returned up to the 40, to the 44, to the 43 actually. Return of 29 yards. That'll be long. It'll be first down. Rodgers, the quarterback for North Carolina. So that was Rodgers actually with the return. He'll stay on at quarterback, first down. He's going to look. He's going to run to the left side, and he's tackled by Hargrove. He gains 5. It'll be second down. So here come the Tar Heels now. After all the turnovers, the Tar Heels have it. It'll be second down. They're only down by 6. Going to run it himself, and that's up the middle. Enough for a first down. Yes, it is. It'll be a first down for North Carolina, and they will have it first and 10. So here comes North Carolina looking good here. First down and 10. They're into Oklahoma A&M territory. And to the left side, Rodgers. He's going to get a couple. Only one, actually. It'll be second down. Justice is the quarterback. And now Rodgers comes back in. So Justice with the last run. And here's Rodgers. It's going to be second down. Back. And Rodgers again. He's going to go to the 45. He gets only a yard. It'll be third and 8. Third and 8. Oklahoma A&M 9. North Carolina 3. Third down. Back is Rodgers to throw. Rodgers looking. He's going to run up the middle. Get a first down to Moore. He fumbles the football. And it is taken away. It's Oklahoma A&M's ball. They fall on it. And Oklahoma A&M gets the ball. And Oklahoma A&M will have it. And it is going to be a first down there. My goodness. What a game. What a game. North Carolina's fumbling away their chance here. So I'm telling you, there are some teams here that are looking mighty good, and we're going to see them. And quite frankly, I think it's going to be an interesting matchup. I really see this as a top-heavy tournament. And I'm seeing that right now. It's going to be first down for Oklahoma A&M, Thomas. And he'll run it himself. I don't think he got anything. Second down, he didn't. And second down now. So Grimes comes in for Reynolds. Second down. And back. They're going to go Thomas to the left-hand side. He's going to get 3. And it's going to be third down and 7. So 95 yards for Thomas. This is his season most. And Fenimore on third down. Oklahoma A&M. Fenimore, he throws, and it's incomplete, a little too long, and now they're going to punt back to North Carolina. So North Carolina not too a good defensive stop here, and the punt, it's going to be out of bounds at the 33-yard line. So very, very big. North Carolina will take over. We're going to keep it here with 5.5 to go here in the third. It's 9-3. First down. Back is Rodgers. He's going to run to the right side. There's going to be a penalty, and let's see what it is.
Holding offense, 10-yard penalty.
And they're going to move it back for the hold, so it'll be first down and 20. First and 20, Rodgers with the, is still the quarterback. He's going to take it. He's going to run to the left-hand side, and he gets nothing there. It'll be second down. Oklahoma 9, North Carolina 3. Second down now. Back to throw. Looking again. He's going to maybe throw deep, and he does. And this was intercepted. And that's a big one. An interception. And Oklahoma A&M will have the ball as Palmer picked it off. And now Oklahoma A&M is going to have a chance. Thomas comes in at quarterback. He's going to have a chance right now. If they win, that's a big win against the top 15 team. They can solidify this. It's going to be first down for Oklahoma A&M. And they give it nothing's going there. Cox with the tackle. They actually lost one. And it's going to be second down. Second down for Oklahoma A&M. It's 9-3. Back. And it's going to be actually the running back. He's going to get almost nothing. And Hankins ran that one. Third down, look at this. It's just a random-looking formation here. Third and 12. Can they get enough yards to do something? Back to throw, a long deep throw. It's caught down to the one-yard line. And it is down for 26 yards. And it's going to be first down and goal. And this might be the football game if they can get it in. It's going to be first down, Oklahoma A&M. First down, Oklahoma A&M. And if they can get this in, it might be over. It's going to be first down, the snap. They're going to take it left side, touchdown. That's Thomas who runs it in. Thomas will score. And Oklahoma A&M has now had a big lead. They now have a huge 15-3 lead. .254-80 in total yards. North Carolina with only 80 total yards. That's it. Only 80 yards. And now the extra point. So Oklahoma will kick the extra point here. And the kick is up. It is over, and this one is good. And it is Oklahoma 16 and North Carolina 3. And this is good so far. So we're going to get it with 2 minutes and 3 seconds to go here in the third quarter. And this is big as Oklahoma State. They are taking a two-score lead. And unlike football today, two scores is an eternity. It's almost like being down two goals in soccer. And it's going to be first down and 10. First and 10 for North Carolina. Rogers the quarterback, and he's going to get nothing there. Second down. My goodness, they've shut them down now. Oklahoma A&M looking good. Second down. Back to throw. Looking to the left side. He might get a yard out of that. He does. And only one. It's going to be third down. Rogers has not completed a pass. Justice is third down. He's the passing quarterback. Third down, Justice, he's going to run to the left side, not get enough. It's going to be fourth down, and now they're going to kick. No, they're going for it. It's going to be fourth down. No, they're not going to run a play. That's going to be it. That's going to be it for the third quarter. They're going to go, and they're going to talk about it. They are going to talk about it. It's going to be very big, and it is the fourth quarter. You gotta feel it. It is Oklahoma State. Oklahoma State's to lose here as we begin the fourth quarter. All these games have been blowouts. About ready to go. Fourth quarter here, Oklahoma A&M. 11 runs of 10 plus yards. Here, and we're about to go to the fourth quarter here. My goodness. You know, that's one of the things that... Here comes the punt here. As we begin the fourth quarter, North Carolina will kick. It's going to go out of bounds here. And a first down for Oklahoma A&M. This is just a... I just want to be honest. This is just a good game for Oklahoma, you know, a little bit early. It's almost like soccer in this age where you can get your rear end blown out and it still looks like 1-0 or whatever. You know, you can have 1-0 blowouts. It's first down. And it's going to be run to the left-hand side and only a gain of 1. It'll be second down. So Oklahoma A&M, they lead 16-3. It'll be second down. Snap. He's going to look. He's going to throw it right to the running back and tackled by Steegman. So they throw it to Reynolds, and Reynolds will get it. It'll be third down and 1. Well, they want to get a first down here and start to work this clock. So they're going to have it. They're going to throw. He's going to throw it, and it's going to be an interception by Justice, and that's intercepted. Justice, it's intercepted, and North Carolina will take over. North Carolina needed a break, and here's Rodgers. It's going to be first down. They need two touchdowns here. First down, Rodgers. Rodgers, he's going to run it. Rodgers, here comes Rodgers down to the 25-yard line, and a first down. So that's big. He's down to the 24. North Carolina getting some yards here. Very, very big. This is exactly what they need. First down, first and 10. Back, Rodgers, and nothing going. He's going to gain 1. Second down. This is 4 down territory. You know it right here. Kohler with 10 tackles today. Second down. Back, Rodgers. He's going to take a look to the left-hand side and maybe get 2. It'll be third down. Third down for North Carolina. 4 turnovers today for Oklahoma. Third down. Back to go. It's going to be a penalty. Let's see what it is. Sacked by Moore. They lose 6. Let's see what this is.
10-yard penalty.
And it is going to be third down. And let's see what it is. It was third down and 7. It'll be 4th and 13. They're going to decline. And they're going for it on fourth down. So this is going to be very big. 4th down and 13. They need it. Justice will be the quarterback. He's 2-6 throwing today. Justice, he's going to run. He runs up the middle. It's no good. They don't have it. He only gets 7 of the 13 yards. And that is big. 7 of the 13 yards. And Oklahoma State will take over. A very big stop for Oklahoma State. And they want to just run this clock out and win this game. Gatorade team of Florida 1966, they're killing Ohio State. Pitt and Nebraska are playing a heck of a game there. UCLA is 21-0 over Boston College. They might go 3-0. Notre Dame and Auburn locked in a really good game. Now we're going to go here, first down and 10. Very big for Oklahoma State. They want to take a lot of time off this clock. Back is Thomas. They hand it off and only getting 2. Off the left side is Reynolds. It'll be second down. Reynolds with 31 yards. today rushing. Fenimore will come in. It'll be at quarterback. Second down, Fenimore, and he'll run it, and he'll get close, and he makes a first down for Oklahoma, and a first down for Oklahoma A&M. Thomas will come in at quarterback. First down, he's thrown two interceptions. They run it, he gets nothing. Second down, no gain. Second down. Snap, back to throw, looking, they throw. It's going to be incomplete. And it's going to be third down. Third down, Fenimore. Third down for Oklahoma State. Back to throw. He throws it, goes to the right-hand side. Masika with the stop. It's going to be fourth down. Fenimore couldn't get the first down, and now they're going to punt. So basically, they're just trying to play very safe and run this clock out and be 3-0. And it'll roll dead at their own 26-yard line. Oh, my. I screwed up there. Right there. I forgot to switch the camera back. But Oklahoma and North Carolina, it's still 16-3 here. Rogers, the quarterback here. It'll be first down and 10. Thank you to the one that is watching here. Thank you very much to the one person watching here. Thank you. That is huge. It's going to be first down. Rodgers, yeah, we'll take it. Rodgers will run to the near side. Here's Rodgers. Goes out of bounds after 7 yards. It'll be second down. North Carolina down by 2 scores. Second down. They're not built to go all the way. Rodgers, a first down and more. Up to about the 48-yard line. A gain of 15. And Rodgers will have it. It'll be first down. Look at North Carolina finally moving the football. And back to throw. Rodgers, he'll run it. He'll get a first down more. Here come Rodgers down to the 35, to the 34-yard line, and a first down. Wow, North Carolina's moving a football. Where was this all day? Where was this? First down for North Carolina. Back to throw. And looking. He's going to run it again. He gets about nothing. It's going to be second down. He's just drawing it the whole time himself. Quarterback draws. Second down and 9. Back is Rodgers, and he's going to be tackled by Moore. And that's going to be a sack there. Third down and 13. Two down territory, nearing 5:21 to go. Rodgers, and he's sacked by Cheek, and it's going to be fourth down. Big fourth down. North Carolina is going to try and punt. And they want to watch out for the fake. The punt will be over to the left-hand side. Not a great one. 30 yards. It's out at the 16. And Oklahoma A&M will have the ball. Here's Thomas on a first down. So Oklahoma A&M, they want to win this game. Right here. First down, Thomas. He's going to throw, and it slipped right through Maynard's hands. Right through Maynard's hands. It's going to be second down. 2 drops today for him. He's a running back and a defensive back. Second down. Fenimore and a quarterback. Back to throw. He's looking like he's going to throw, and it's incomplete. He tried to hit Armstrong. Third down. Why is Oklahoma A&M trying to throw the football? Third down. Back is Fenimore. He's going to run it up the middle, and does he get enough? He gets enough for a first down. He ran it himself, and that's going to be huge. Now North Carolina is going to start using timeouts. Thomas is the quarterback. This means that first down means an onside kick. First down. Back the throw. It's going to be complete back to the running back and a first down. Very, very big, and a first down for Oklahoma A&M. I think they're just going to run this clock out. North Carolina having 3 timeouts. First down. Snap, they're going to get a running back. He's going to take it justice with the stop. And that was just a terrible, terrible pitch. Timeout by North Carolina. It'll be second down. 1:53 to go. Back. The throw is Thomas. He's going to run the football. Here's Thomas, the first down and more. Thomas down to about the 39-yard line. 119 yards today for Thomas. 14 rushes, 119 yards. He has 2 touchdowns today, and he's averaging 8.5. And this game is pretty much going to be over. This game is pretty much over here, and this is basically just running out the clock. First down and 10 for Oklahoma A&M. The run up the middle, they're just playing it safe there. A gain of one, it'll be second down. So second down, North Carolina with their final timeout. So Oklahoma A&M, they're going to look good. They're just going to take a knee here and end this game. And it'll be third down. So third down, they're going to actually run the football. And that's Fenimore. He got 102 yards for Fenimore. And they have 262 today. And this should be it. They are going to take a knee. And that's it. Oklahoma A&M wins the football game over North Carolina 16-3. In a game in which, well, I mean, quite frankly, it was not the greatest game in the world. It was a game in which I would say that it has been, there's the stats right here. Let's take a look. The 10-minute ticker goes off right here, and let's take a look at this game. So North Carolina 16-3. When you take a look at the stats for the game, Oklahoma A&M looking very good. They are looking good. The offensively 45 rushes, 269 yards. They were 4 of 13 throwing the ball. They did fumble four times. It was pouring down rain. And they did have 13 runs of over 10 yards, though. The thing that I wondered about them, they're 4 of 11 third downs, and the fact that they couldn't put it in. They had the four turnovers, which was very, very big, all four fumbles. Whereas the interception by North Carolina, that was big there. And taking a look, so the complete here, taking a look here, you take a look at all the quarterbacks and everything. So passing, Thomas and Fenimore, both two completions. Interceptions, actually, three total for Oklahoma State. For North Carolina, they fumbled four times. They had four turnovers, but they fumbled just means they fumbled. They had, Rogers had one interception. He was 0 of 3. They were 2 of 9 total in passing. Rushing 84 yards for Rogers. They had Oklahoma A&M, which is Oklahoma State had 221 yards by two players. And now to our post-game show. All right, well, now we're going to see how everybody did. We're going to see how everybody did as we go back to the Ray Grigge League. And we take a look here. Very, very good. And we're going to... We're going to be ready to go, so here we go. This is the week three, all of the scores. Let's take a look at week three, all of the scores. So we're going to take a look at the schedule and everything. So everywhere you can see everything. Villanueva, another good game. So let's take a look. Maryland beat Minnesota 30-21. They're now 2-1. Felton had 91 yards rushing and two touchdowns. Army beat Arkansas 7-3. Dawkins had 44 yards. He also made three tackles. He went both ways. Notre Dame beat Notre Dame 35-7. The 1941 Notre Dame team, they get their first win. Juswick for 98 yards. That's pretty good. Alabama of 1945 played a tough game against Michigan. So don't say that Alabama was invincible. Texas A&M beat Illinois 14-7. Crow had 167 yards and a touchdown for Texas A&M. They're 2-1. Kentucky goes to 3-0 against Maryland, a 7-6 win. That was big. Minnesota beat Texas 14-0 there. Florida beat Ohio State 34-14. So Syracuse beat Louisiana State LSU 38-3. Syracuse giving up 3 points. Oklahoma 54 beat Wisconsin 21-14. Michigan State 13-7 over Wyoming. Wyoming can't score worth anything. Southern Cal, they're still undefeated. Navy of 1960 hasn't won a game. Southern Cal's 2-0-1. They won 26-14. Oklahoma A&M, a 16-3 win. That's what we saw here. The game about as interesting as throwing golf balls against a blender. So we have that here. Mississippi 21, losing to Alabama in a battle of the winless, and Alabama gets on track. Nebraska beat Pitt 36-20. And UCLA 21-0 over Colorado. Scoring plays, Villanueva, I believe he was the quarterback. Yeah, Villanueva, a heck of a runner. 28 rushes for 142 yards and 2 touchdowns. He could be the best player in the game. Notre Dame is 64, beat Auburn by 1 point, 27-26. Army won 26-0. They still haven't given up a point. That's a scary football team. Minnesota 33-0 there. Louisiana State against Purdue. LSU beats Purdue 13-10. Georgia beat Ohio State by 3. Notre Dame beat Notre Dame by 17. 19, those mid-40s Notre Dames were unbelievable. Washington 13-7 over Texas. Tennessee goes to 3-0. They beat Michigan State 37-7. Michigan beat Georgia Tech 20-0. Indiana wins. Indiana, Penn State didn't throw the ball once. Penn State threw the ball once. It was Petchel. But rushing, it was just that game was a brutal game. Michigan beat Michigan State 23-7. Tennessee and Navy. Navy wins that game. And Navy ends up winning that football game. Navy wins that football game. You got to see this. Watch Navy. They were down 32-10. They were down 32-10 in the third quarter. Staubach ran again. Donnelly, 11-yard run, and then 47 seconds to go. They come back with an incredible comeback. Captain comeback, as they call him, and 56 Tennessee goes down. Oh, my goodness. Navy goes to 2-1. Tennessee 42-20 over Wisconsin. Iowa beats Wisconsin 62. Wisconsin, they're winless. Iowa 24-7. Oklahoma 19-50, a tough football team. 28-7 they lead. And Kansas gets their first win as they beat Iowa. Take a look at all the standings, the leaders. 1950 Tennessee and 40 Minnesota. 1950 Tennessee, they group A. Group B, Kentucky and Syracuse. That should be a good one. Group C, this UCLA team's unbelievable. Group D, Army, Notre Dame, Minnesota. Army, Notre Dame. Those two are very good. Group E, Alabama and Minnesota. Group F, Michigan State and Southern Cal. They both have a tie. They're both 2-0-1. Group G, Oklahoma A&M is the only one that's 3-0. And Group H, remember, you only play 12 games. Group H, Oklahoma is 3-0 here. So very, very big. Let's take a look at the next game right here. Let's take a look at so far everything that is happening. Now the power rankings. Very, very big for the power rankings. Oh, look at this. It is, oh my God, you can't even see that font. Yeah, you got to get that a little bit more. And there it is. So the font there, and we're about ready to go. The power rankings now. Let's take a look. Let's go all the way down from the bottom to the top. The power rankings reveal is right now. So here we go. So the worst team is Wisconsin, and we work our way up. Wisconsin is absolutely blisteringly terrible. We take a look. Pitt is 49th. Taking a look up. Maryland, Michigan State. Louisiana State, Florida. Florida looking all right, but beating terrible teams. Now here we take a look. 16 is maybe. You're assuming that all the division winners are going to be within the top 16. If that helps, then that means Minnesota's the last playoff team. Michigan State. Remember the eight division winners and then the eight highest-ranked wildcards. Michigan in 1940. Notre Dame, Minnesota, they're 2-1. Kentucky is 3-0. Tennessee, 2-1. Michigan, 2-1. Syracuse at 3-0. Tennessee, a 1956 a drop. And here we go. UCLA at 3-0. Oklahoma at 3-0. Alabama, 1945 at 3-0. Tennessee at 3-0. And Army. Army at 3-0. And that is it. Navy of 1963. Navy with the comeback. My God, they're looking at that as a fluke. Navy's 27th. You got to think that Navy winning that game, they're going to go up, but Navy still has to win more games. But so Army first, Tennessee second, Alabama third, Oklahoma fourth, and UCLA is fifth. And right now, this is as people play, you get more data points. You get way more data points here. So that's going to be it for us today. Now, tomorrow we're going to take a look here. And we're going to take a look at all the games tomorrow. Week number 4. Oh, I see a big one. I see a very big one. Let's take a look at everything that we see. We see a big game, and let's see, and here it is. I see early on Minnesota and Alabama, Minnesota and Alabama. Alabama favored by 10. Take a look at all the other games. Navy, Maryland, Southern Cal, Penn State, Michigan State. UCLA is 3-0. They play Nebraska. Oklahoma A&M against Iowa. That'll be good. Auburn and Minnesota. There are 3-0s everywhere, and you just got to see who's going to be good and what and where. Pitt and Boston College. And when you take a look at Pitt and Boston College, the whole thing is who can beat 54 UCLA. But Pitt will take Boston College on. Tennessee and Army. Tennessee is there. Notre Dame against Ohio State. Notre Dame favored by 10. And Indiana doing good, Texas A&M, Michigan again. Right now, Oklahoma favored by 20 in their game. Wisconsin, North Carolina favored by 21. So if I'm taking a look, I'm looking at 54 UCLA. I'm looking at 45 Army. They play Georgia, and Army's favored by 26 points against 1959 Georgia. Army looks very solid. In fact, when you take a look at the Army team, as we leave here, I want to take a look. Army is incredible. 1945 Army. 1945 Army, as you take a look. Now we're going to go to them. A very quick synopsis. Them and Notre Dame, they've outscored everybody 82-0. So Army on the road. This is the number one team. Army on the road. Oh my goodness. Look at this. A 36-0 win over Wisconsin. A 20-0 win against Ohio State. And 26-0. Against UCLA. Their defense is one of the best in the game. Their offense is ranked 9th. They rush the ball very well. They pass the ball all right. But they're very, very good in what they do. And looking at their schedule, oh, they got 64 Notre Dame. That might be a heck of a football game. That might be one of the best games. All right, that's going to be it for us today. We will see you tomorrow. Check out the website, and please help me out checking out the website. It should be fun. Thank you for watching. We'll see you tomorrow. Minnesota Who is it again? Minnesota of 1960 and Alabama of 1945 in Alabama. We're going to see you tomorrow.